Just 1 month to the day after 17-year-old Paige Johnson vanished, a vigil in her honor.
News 5's Brian Hamrick updates us on the investigation and tonight's benefit. He's live in Covington. Brian?
Yeah, Jack, well, they're preparing for this vigil here in Covington tonight. Tonight, you can see they got the tents up here already. They're expecting a pretty good crowd out here this evening, beginning at 7. Friends, family expected here, including Paige's mother, but they're careful not to call this a memorial.
Yeah, absolutely. It's the effort before the vigil.
We've been working on this morning, getting candles ready for tonight.
Those who come will be clutching these candles, but what they'll be holding on to is hope. Lisa Little is organizing the event.
In no way, shape, or form are we having this as a way to say goodbye to Paige. We believe that she's still alive, and that's what we want this to be about tonight.
Paige Johnson is a 17-year-old who was reported missing 1 month ago, tomorrow. Jacob Bumpus was the last person known to see her. He's in jail for probation violations. Police searched his home and the property around it this month. Now, we got exclusive access to it. Markings left show areas searched. Documents mention latex gloves. We found these still inside. And red paint, we found this. Also mentioned was a red substance resembling dried blood. We found some of that, too, here on the sink. I watched as a landlord, so convinced it was not blood, put her finger in it and tasted it, told us it was red Kool-Aid. However, definitive police lab tests have not been released.
Of course, police have taken everything out of there they think that they're going to need, so they turned that apartment back over to the landlord and the folks who live there. Meanwhile, they're getting ready again for this vigil this evening. They're hoping to raise money here as well, hoping to raise money for Paige's daughter and for that reward that's already up to $1,000. Reporting live, Brian Hamrick, News 5.